It's day four, but there may be a hopeful sign for airline passengers stranded by the volcanic ash cloud over Europe, because KLM says it has flown a plane through the ash with no apparent problems. And this just in, Air France says it has safely carried out a test flight from Paris to Toulouse in southern France. The airline says it will conduct a total of 5 test flights today. Meanwhile, British Airways and Irish airline Aer Lingus are already canceling all their flights for tomorrow. But British Airways reportedly plans to carry out a test flight of its own later this evening. So for more on the ash cloud's impact on travel, I'm joined now live by travel expert Valerie Delia with TravelWithVal.com. Good morning.
Good morning, Alex.
I know you were going to head over to London. Your flight got canceled because of all this. So what do you have in terms of advice for folks who are holding a ticket, but that flight's not going anywhere?
Okay, that's not going anywhere. The airline has canceled it on you. You can get a refund or you can rebook it without penalty. So those are really your two options here.
Okay, so you've got some options there. Does travel insurance factor into anything here in terms of helping you out?
Well, it's very interesting because this is called a natural disaster or adverse weather. So you have to read very carefully your policies. It could cover some expenses such as your trip cancellation. Let's say you need a hotel when you're canceled and you're stranded, your trip is interrupted, the trip's delayed. It's a missed connection, but sometimes it will only cover you if your departing airport is closed. So if you're going New York to London and the London airport is closed, you're not covered because your departing airport isn't closed.
Ooh.
So it's very dicey. You have to be very careful about that.
Yeah, but travel insurance is not going to get stuck with the bill for flights itself, because the other two options you said earlier, people can pretty much make good with that. They can either rebook their flights or they can get their money back.
That's right. You can rebook without a penalty in most cases, but in all cases, you can get your money back if the airline cancels on you, even if it is a non-refundable ticket. But people are saying, well, yeah, okay, I'm going to get my money back, but I had this planned or that planned, and how am I ever going to get compensated for that? That you're not going to get compensated for.
Val, are you hearing stories about the issues at hotels? I mean, I'm envisioning scenarios where people are staying at a hotel. They can't get anywhere, so they're hoping to stay on at hotels, but then you've got other bookings.
And
what are you hearing?
Well, New York City, Mayor Bloomberg is giving 15% off across the city at 30 different hotels to people stranded in New York. But what I'm finding on the Twitterverse, I guess it is, the grassroots network of people coming together, and they're going to like hashtag get me home or put me up. And people are advertising the fact that they're in need of a couch or a bed. And people are reacting to that, and people are giving free space to these people. So I'm thinking that the grassroots effort and the social media is really the way to go in a situation like this.
Well, it makes some sense. And you know, whatever you got to do, make it work. But the Twitterverse, I'm sure it's helping.
It's helping.
Okay, Valerie Delia, thank you.
You're welcome.
Just a short time ago, the state funeral service